Edna!
She don't care.
What?
Pull over!
No!
Oh, well, I guess I'll leave.
Perfect. I said you're gonna roll the window down.
I thought you were gonna have to use the windshield wiper for something.
I did. I had to use it to close the Mr. Fusion. That's all it was for.
I thought you still had. Oh.
I still have it, but that's all it was. I think that. Pretty sure that's all it was for.
Nicely done. Now, aim the sink.
Are they gonna, like, remote control the vehicle with this?
They're gonna sync it up so they. I don't know, dude. I wasn't paying enough attention.
Oh, can you do it upside down?
I didn't give enough fuck. Oh my god. So much fucking. Stop it.
Are you good enough to realign these satellite dishes?
God damn. So tedious.
That's it. Get out of there, Marty.
Also, don't touch the beams. They're full of deadly radiation.
Don't touch the beams and then have kids. Because they'll come out as aliens.
No, no, Doc, what are you doing?
Oh my god, Doc. Just crushes him.
Now what? Now we take control of that destroyer with a...
And crash her into a fucking wall.
What? According to these readings, the temporal cohesion of that destroyer is decaying.
Yeah, that thing.
English, Doc.
We've got to get Edna home.
Okay.
In Spanglish.
Hold on!
We're controlling you now, Edna. Yeah.
Holy shit!
Oh, good.
Now she's arrested.
Yes.
You're going straight to jail!
All is right with the world now.
All's right with the world, that it wouldn't have needed to be righted if Doc would have just left it alone.
Right.
I'm gonna visit my old town back in the past and fuck everything up.
Parker, then I must be back in... Would you be kind enough to tell me what day it is?
It's the day I place you under arrest for arson, resisting arrest, and being a general all-round pain in the ass.
What?
Oh, no.
Can't arrest me. Not now.
Woe is me.
Would you look at that? Edna Strickland, drunk as a skunk.
I'm not drunk, you reprobate. I'm a time traveler.
Sure you are. I'm loving this.
I'll
bring it to you. Come with me. We can do the whole day over if you want. We can fix anything.
We can start by drying you out. Come on, into the station
of
with you.
Of course.
You can bunk with me, dog.
The most anti-alcohol person in town is obviously drunk.
You dolt.
Don't worry about the future machine either.
I guess that's
it. What are we
going to
do with the copy machine?
Yes, I suppose it is. You know, whoever said time heals all wounds didn't know squat about time.
What do we do about that, DeLorean?
No need to do a thing. Ever since we synced up the time circuits, the temporal breakdown in Edna's DeLorean has accelerated at an exponential
rate. Whatever that means,
it's just going to disappear.
The timeline should catch up with it in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. No.
What the hell? Hey, Parker, you're not gonna believe this.
No, he's not. Say,
ready to go home?
Wait, Doc, the timeline's not fixed yet.
Einstein.
Look. Michael, you missed all the fireworks at the expo.
Really? There was fireworks for that expo?
Listen,
that looked like a high school science fair.
I guess we gotta come clean. Ta-da! Marty took me to Reno.
That's not her.
Night.
Trixie's not her real name.
Secret in Hill Valley.
Well, you're gonna congratulate
no.
us.
No,
I did call it. That was totally his
and
grandma the whole time.
You did.
Grandpa's married the wrong grandma. I'm done for.
Hey, are you feeling all right, kid? You don't look
you're
so.
You're starting to turn invisible. It ain't right.
It just ain't.
It just isn't right. Now, I know marrying a Canadian for a work permit isn't strictly by the book, but pay.
Why does this game hate Canadians? What happened?
For these filthy Canadians.
They snuck it in this episode.
Trixie, you can't marry Artie.
Is this about my past with Kid? Cause Audie ain't holding that against me.
That's right, darling.
It's all these damned.
Yes. How could you? But how could you say no to those Bazonga Wongas?
Can you see through me?
Nope. Never could figure you out. I thought you'd be thrilled for us.
Instead, you're being a cunt.
You're supposed to marry Sylvia Miskin.
But I did marry Sylvia Miskin.
What?
You didn't think my real name was Trixie Trotta, did ya?
Christ.
Don't feel
you just
too
think
bad.
My name is Trixie's
daughter.
It was
kind of a surprise to me, too.
Wait a minute. Your grandma, Sylvie?
Grandma? Hey, how old do you think I am?
It depends on what
but
year
you're
talking about.
So skinny and blonde and
Bazonga Wongas.
Gams.
Oh my god. I've seen you naked. You're Sylvia?
Yeah, when did he see her naked?
Pal? Yeah, I'm fine. Great. You kids go off and have yourself a wonderful honeymoon. And don't worry about your dad, Artie. I'm sure he'll come around.
Oh, wait. I think... No.
Come around to what? to approving your marriage. You seem kind of mad about it back at the high school.
Well, that was before I got a look at her.
I saw her big old titties.
Seamus used to say, no sense in getting riled up over something I can't do nothing about.
I'm powerless.
Now that I met her...
He was just jealous that his son got such a hot chick.
Thank you, Dad.
Don't call me fucking
Dad. Now, big
kiss
on the mouth.
As for you,
kiss
stranger,
me on the dick.
I'll thank you when I go put my nose in the Fly family business.
Kiss me below the belt.
It's been a kiss pleasure, like Agent Corleone.
See you in the funny papers, Mikey.
They're gonna go after
they all get hit by a car.
Yeah.
You know...
It'll finally pay off.
Pictures of Trixie in 1931.
Hey, that's my grandma you're talking about.
Yeah, it is.
When did that happen?
Who knows? Who cares? This game doesn't even know when that happened. I'm just saying it did because they don't give
a
shit
anymore. Oh no, they rezoned my house as a parking lot.
Here we are, back in good old 1986.
May 14th?
15th. Best to build in a little lag time. Gives you a chance to catch up.
Looks like the estate sale is still going
on.
Hey, don't you want to stay, Doc? You gotta stop the bank from selling off all
he's
the old
stuff. He's selling
I have
off his old
life.
Stuff.
What are you talking about? Estate sale bank? I'm not dead, Marty. Clara and I are having a little garage sale, that's all.
Yeah.
Garage sale?
He's selling his own
you
stuff.
You mean, Marty, you're back from your trip. Hello, Doc. Selling off
the family
treasure.
But he basically just came out of the building. Of course you know he's selling.
Did you find what you were looking for?
Sure.
Yeah, I sure did. Great. Hey, is that a box of Asimov?
Of acid?
No, it's a box of cyanide.
Let me get this straight. Are you telling me you live here now? In 1986?
With your future wife?
Well, naturally.
Past wife,
future?
Part-time residents here. Wasn't that the case when you left?
No.
Strange. I can't imagine not sticking around. After all, I've got my late father's foundation to supervise. If I wasn't here, who'd present the annual Earhart Brown Scholarship for Young Scientists? Something funny?
I'll explain it to you later.
I don't see what's so funny about looking after a family legacy. Oh, almost forgot. I've got something.
A gun! It's a bunch of hits of acid. We're gonna trip balls tonight. Fuck Claire and the kids.
Yeah.
I'm leaving that bitch.
Graduation?
But that's not for another
year.
2 years ago.
The McFlys of Hill Valley.
An exhaustively detailed history of your family. From your great-great-grandfather, Seamus.
I'm a bit obsessed.
You traveled through
time. I've been watching you for a long time.
The research was done traditionally, but your grandma Sylvia proved to be something of a mystery.
Which is why you traveled back to 1931 to look for her.
What? So he didn't even come to rescue him. He just was looking for his grandma.
Jesus Christ.
This is great.
What a
guy.
This game
thanks.
Is.
It's the least I can
this
do
game's
a man
story
who
hates
saved me from
hates
the
you.
Worst mistake of my life.
It hates us both.
Dr. Brown.
Edna?
You forgot your fucking dog.
In 1931.
He should be dead.
He's 150 years old now.
Same thing I do every afternoon, silly man.
Giving him such much needed exercise. Isn't that right, Einstein?
Hey,
Hey, dollface, it's past time for our 3:30.
Coming, sweetie! Oh, Mr. McFly, have you seen my stepson anywhere?
Oh, Biff, I think you're late for an appointment.
Psychiatrist.
Look, gosh,
you're late for an appointment at the morgue. Bam!
Hi, Marty.
Don't they make a great little family? You'd never know they met in prison.
Well, they met in jail. Not
Christ. Oh, my God.
Don't say anything. Let's just walk quietly.
Just let it happen, man. Let it be.
No more surprises.
God, that ground texture is awful.
Yeah, it's too much.
It's off. It looks like Minecraft gravel. And I mean old Minecraft gravel.
I bet that's the end, too.
Oh, no. Oh, God. Oh, God. Nobody cares. Is this like a tease? Is this like a season 2 tease?
Oh.
That they did, but never made it anywhere.
We have to kill him.
Marty, you can't be here. If your younger self sees you,
he just did.
This could be catastrophic.
My younger self? Oh, right.
You're looking at him.
Yeah, literally right there.
What do you mean? Does something happen to us?
Do we turn into assholes or something?
Yeah.
Nah, we're fine.
You turn into assholes and agree to make a game like this.
What the hell?
Great Scott.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
I don't know what's happening here.
Too much.
Doc, you gotta come back with me. Listen to him, Doc. It's me you gotta help. If you wanna save Jennifer and our 12 kids.
What? That timeline was overridden 5 jumps back.
Doc, Jennifer's... how can there be 2 more of me here?
I have no idea. My all rights are supposed to continue.
We catastrophically fucked up the time.
Yep.
It already is. What my evil twin and I are trying to say is the future is totally jacked up, and you gotta come with me to save it. No, me!
This is retarded.
So, we meet at last.
What the fuck?
You've altered my timeline once too often.
They're gonna kill each
What's
other,
going
no!
On, Doc?
Well, we do seem to have a conundrum on our hands. Or 3.
Yeah, Doc, but which one is the real me?
Isn't it obvious, Marty?
None of them.
They all are. Ha ha.
Come on.
We have to pick your future today.
Prepare to be erased. Doc, wait. What about the space-time continuum?
Yeah, what about my future? And mine?
The future can wait. We've got a present to catch up with.
What the fuck, your shit?
Yeah,
it's like
cares?
They had to fucking draw dice at the end where they're just like, nope.
God damn. It really is, though.
Please help us.
Yeah,
no.
Nah, I'm good. Fuck you guys.
Oh.
That's actually how it ended, isn't it?
Oh.
Oh shit. Oh, 4.3% of people have completed this game all the way.
Oh my god. That's too surprising.
Yeah, that's a high number. That's still a pretty high number.
We have to see who passed Marty, or future Marty.
No, it would have been Marty's great-great-grandfather.
Whatever, but it's still him in the future, too. It's the same model.
I'm just saying. Marty McFly, AJ, nope.
Performed by Michael J. Fox, William Knight, future!
Oh, man.
Oh, God.
That sucks.
They roped both of these
assholes. They roped him into
this.
It just for a little cameo. I knew that was him.
Oh, my God.
I thought that was Michael J. Fox's voice. He's very distinct.
No, it's wow. not going to be continued.
They really thought they were going to get another one. Wow. They really thought really they were going to get another one. You thought wrong.
Great minds in the Telltale office. Okay. So we should watch that video.
To be continued. I certainly hope not. I certainly hope it's not continued ever.
Yeah, I never want to see Back to the Future the game 2.
No. That it would just probably be
Back to the Future.
Season 2 kind of thing like they do with The Walking Dead.
Yeah, I guess so.
Back to the Future, the other game.
Play video.
Oh, it's like a... Oh, yeah. It's them sucking their own dick. You really want to watch this shit?
I want an explanation. I don't think they'll be able to
the
give it to
history of Back to the Future video mm-hmm. games has not been a pretty one. And so, my mandate to Telltale when they said
is
we're going to
do
Back
made...
to the Future
yes.
is this game cannot suck eggs.
The century looks bright for our fair
of
metropolis.
Course, our residents will want to enter the U.S.
Could this be our venerable artificial rainstorm drenches the valley thirsty crop?
I was aware of his frustration at previous attempts at making a game. Definitely, like the first time we met, we talked about that. You know, with Telltale, our process starts with the story and the characters, and we apply the story mechanics later. And I think that people were really excited about the potential of where this could go, because we really want to protect the license, and you know, also for us, like getting Bob Gale's sign-off was everything.
There's never going to be a Back to the Future Part 4. We're not doing that. But Telltale's Back to the Future game is pretty close to what a Part 4 could be.
Arthur McFly? Yeah? Got something for you.
Thanks. A subpoena?
Making a Telltale game is sort of modeled after the TV episodic model, where we, instead of telling one story at once, we tell a bunch of stories that are all connected over the course of a season. So in Back to the Future's case, it was 5 episodes. So first we figure out like the really rough story arc.
If you want to call it that.
Yeah, no, you could definitely call it a rough story arc.
The flames look better in that preview.
Yes, everything looked better in that preview. Where's that game at?
Right.
Go back. It's not the one we played.
Because this was an idea that Bob Zemeckis and I had had way early on when we were trying to figure out what Back to the Future Part 2 was going to be about.
And instantly, like, all of the fans in the room just went...
Yeah, let's ruin the series completely.
All the fans in the room, okay.
And it was all just a matter of...
All
okay,
one
well,
of them.
We have this basic fired idea. Immediately.
Yeah.
How do we get the player involved?
He was given an immediate promotion for being on board.
And so... We started there.
We showed him our ideas, and he just started screaming.
Doc getting stranded back in time. Then
it was like the premiere of Jaws in 1970. Well, 73, I think, or whatever it came out. People puked.
Okay.
They cried.
The thing we were most worried about.
There was blood coming out of the one girl's ears.
Well, the best part of the Telltale.
The one guy straight up just jumped right out the window.
Fans of the movie, and they want to get
like the end of the video has like a dedication to all the team members that killed themselves in the
yeah,
making of the game.
All the sacrifices.
Really important part of the process for us was getting the actual actors from the movie to be involved.
A lot of weird goat names at the end.
When the game was first pitched, we said we have to get Christopher Lloyd if we're going to be doing Doc Brown.
I wonder how much Christopher Lloyd regrets this.
I think it's great.
Like, if he played the game afterwards and was like, oh, shit.
It's certainly timely. I mean, video games are hot. And this is great material. I mean, it should be a lot of fun.
That junk looks awfully familiar. 50 years familiar. You in there, Einie? Or whatever your name is these days. Not a sign of him.
Great Scott!
Having Tom Wilson come back for some
Who?
Voiceover now is
we're at Biff. They got real Biff.
Take one.
You're lucky you're old
I didn't
man.
Even
That
realize.
Didn't sound like him at all. That's crazy. Biff was doing a bad Biff impersonation.
Like
that's fucked up.
Yeah, I didn't even look at that this whole time.
His neck more. He uses his jaw. More than I do, you know, things like that. So with every character in the movie, I would think about those.
They're
things.
All just the same character
so it's
with
there.
Different skins.
I don't have to watch
yeah.
everything, because I remember those cues also.
I wonder if he did all the brothers too.
Oh God! So much,
but as probably. I don't want this image on my screen right
now. This isn't what is he having sex? To get he's finishing there. That's not what we want.
All right, for this scene, we're gonna need you to come.
Claudia Wells come
we're
in
gonna
too,
need
like
you to ejaculate.
I think right off the
there's
bat,
a bucket there for you, Biff.
Well, and heard that
my name's Tom. No, shut up, Biff.
What the hell? We're gonna treat him like Biff.
Always call him Biff and treat him like shit.
And be the voice of one of the McFly ancestors.
Well, yeah, so when we were trying to get
we couldn't get Michael J. Fox to sit in for the interview. But
due to time, we couldn't get him to sit still for the interview.
But we got him to do the cameo, which was awesome. And I almost feel like that was a really, almost a cooler use of him nowadays. But then the search turned to, how do we find someone to do a Marty who can just come in and be our main character? And it was a really big worry for a while.
I voiced Marty McFly in Back to the Future of the game. That is what I did.
Jesus Christ, Doc, you disintegrated Einstein!
Pressure, yeah. To be like, oh, you know that amazing, iconic role that everyone loves and knows and can quote lines from, and that incredibly famous, wonderful actor, Michael J. Fox, can you just replicate that? That's what I had going on in the back of my head. So yeah, it was a lot of pressure.
At one point, we got an email from our accountant who said that she'd gotten emailed an MP3 from some kid who said he would like to be Marty in the Back to the Future game.
I heard about this. I saw a news article, Telltale Games making Back to the Future and Jurassic Park into a game. And I was like, wow, that looks awesome. I would love to be, the voice of Marty McFly, but there's no way in hell that's gonna happen. And at the time, Telltale was a lot smaller, so you just have to Google Telltale to get like a list of phone numbers. And Rhoda was the first name that popped up, so I called her. And I left a message that was basically this nerdy, like, hey, my name is Angelo Cassio, I do a great Marty. I tried to sound as much like Marty as I could. I was like, it's my density to have this role.
But I remember it going across someone's desk, them hearing this audition and just saying, man, this kid sounds exactly like Michael J. Fox when he was young.
Doc, you gotta listen to me. The bruise on your head, I know how that happened. You told me the whole story.
It was almost no discussion. It was just kind of, yeah, we heard that MP3 that I think he recorded on like a Rock Band microphone with like, it was just insane, but it was that good.
AJ's Marty McFly is damn near flawless. When I heard his voice, I couldn't believe it.
I mean, I listened to it, and if I didn't know that this was not Michael, I would have assumed it was.
He was such a crucial piece to have that energy throughout the entire series, so it was amazing working with him.
I was obsessed with the movies growing up, like obsessed with Back to the Future. So it was like, it was something that was always in the back of my head. It was just a silly party trick at, you know, what went from a social thing to party trick to actually becoming very useful.
So, Jennifer.
Uh-huh.
What do you think of me?
I don't.
Working on this from a fan perspective was the most pressure I've ever felt on anything. Trying to invent a way where we can pull you along through the story and then use dialogue options where you get to choose what Marty's gonna say. And I think that's the kind of hook for us, is giving you a situation and then saying, well, here's three different ways or four different ways that Marty could possibly react. If you were playing Marty, what would you do? And I think that it allows people to really author their own story.
Telltale's Back to the Future game is the only game that deserves to be called Back to the Future.
Heavy. It's locked.
It's very true to the spirit of the movies. The voice acting is terrific.
That's a good one, sir.
The characterization is great.
Curious. Oh, wait, don't touch it. It's evidence. Of what?
And with the new consoles, the game is just going to sparkle and jump off the screen.
Bringing this game to a new generation, even though it's not that old, is actually super exciting. Like, getting to debut it again on all the new platforms. Telltale's got a lot bigger of a fan base now, and there's a lot of people who probably didn't know that we made this game. But it's still got a lot of the same core principles that are fun in a Telltale game. You know, we're taking this thing that's super familiar and we're putting our own story in it and allowing you to play it. So in time with the 30th anniversary of the films, now we're getting to kind of add to what's out there in the media and saying, like, you know, you're rebuying the movie again and watching it. Here's a game you might enjoy as well. And it kind of, you know, watch the movies first, get back the nostalgia, and then right after the movie ends, you can pop in the game and continue the story from there.
Oh, thank God that's over, too.
Oh. Oh, well. Yeah, that's that.
We'll be back, and we're going to play a good game next time, I swear.
Make better decisions.